Let's say you have two rows of text in a box and you want the size of the box to automatically change to the longest text. So how do we achieve this? First, you create two text layers and one shape layer and place them in the same order as you can see in this video. Then we are going to separate the size values to make it easier for us to adjust them individually later on. In order for me to make it easier to understand what's going on, I'm going to use a metaphor here and pretend that this composition is a school class trying to achieve something together. Let's call this class 6B. First, we're going to add two new students or effects by going to the effect controls and search for slider control. Let's name them Justin and Kelsey. They both have arms or sliders they can use to do things with. Now we want to give them a task each. We want Justin to control the width of the classroom, or shape, and Kelsey to control the height of the classroom, or shape. The way we assign them these tasks is by going to the task itself, which is the size property, and we hold down Option or Alt while clicking on the stopwatch next to size. Now we name the task, for example, fix the width, and assign it to the student or effect, Justin, and in particular, Justin's arms or slider. Now we want the second task, fix the height, to be assigned to Kelsey's arms. What we have left to do is to define the tasks. We do this by typing two brackets with 0 and 1 in them, separated by a comma. This line of code is controlling the values in this property. So by replacing 0 with fix the width and 1 with fix the height, you are saying that these values are now up to Justin and Kelsey to decide. So now when we have assigned the tasks to Justin and Kelsey, we want to check in with them to see how they are doing. Apparently, Kelsey is a bit lazy and says that the height of the classroom or shape doesn't have to change while using it because the classmates or text won't grow that much. So it can be the same at all times. Fair enough, the height of the text won't change because it's capital letters, so this is an easy task. We just use her arms or slider to type in the value. Justin, on the other hand, wants to become a digital nomad with passive income, so he wants to automate this process and create a responsive width of the classroom or shape. This requires more work up front, so we are going to hold Option or Alt while clicking on the stopwatch next to his arms or slider. Here we are using the function mathmax to adjust the width of the classroom or shape to the same value as whatever value is the biggest out of name width and title width. So Justin basically divided his task into two subtasks that he is now outsourcing. So now we need to define these tasks and assign them to two of Justin's classmates. Just like we did with the size property, we need to assign them before we define them, which feels a bit backwards, but that's just how it is. It's kind of like when you ask someone for a favor before telling them what to do. So above your function, you assign the task name width to this comp, the class 6B, layer big brother, your classmate, and source rec at time and width. So whenever Big Brother eats a burger and becomes wider, then the classroom or shape also becomes wider. No idea if that made sense, but that's the best metaphor I can come up with. Now assign the task title width to your other classmate in the same class. So this comp, layer younger brother, and source rec at time and width. Just to clarify what's going on, Justin is now saying that the width of the classroom or shape is determined by whoever eats the most burgers of your bigger brother and your smaller brother, whom both happens to be in the same school class as you for some reason. You can also add some extra constant padding to the width if you want to, if your brother decided to order some extra fries to his burger, for example. So now your two brothers can visit any restaurant they want and their classroom will expand its width accordingly. Pretty handy, right? I hope you liked this video, and if you want to see more quick tutorials just like this one, please subscribe to the channel and check out my playlists about After Effects, Premiere Pro, and Final Cut. And if you want to support my channel, click the super thanks button below this video so I can buy myself some fries. Thanks for watching, keep learning, and have a great day!